Let go this rap shit. There's no relaxing every cross I throw with passion. Talking uppercuts after that your throat I'm jabbing. Shut you the hell up, bringing your cerebellum. Get your bell rung, soon as the bell rung. Your corner know you're corny, but since they don't care to tell them. L-lit, stay giving out L, son. Perk smell, shirt, yeah. Know where I hail from. You already know. You see the body bag, black trunks with the logo. Yeah, I ain't gotta brag.
Y'all know what I
do. I ain't shit. That nigga Red said, you better be ready this time, bro.
He said he ain't ready this time.
Just let you know, that's what he said.
He said he ain't ready this time, but it's going to come all down the middle, and we're going to find something that we agree on again.
That ain't the goal. Y'all ain't supposed to be agreeing, though.
Nah, I'm going to try to stay on my best.
Hey, it was the ones and twos, but I just feel it. I feel it coming, because I'm looking at their damn numbers, you know what I'm saying, looking at their stats and damn side by side, and
Stop picking the top of that curve his way. That's what's going on.
Did you see the fight last night?
Which one?
The J-Rock fight.
Oh, man. J-Rock was a one-hit wonder.
I think I'm going to use that on my show. I'ma still let from you, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to you, you know what I'm saying? I'ma do a couple one hit wonder songs and shit, you know what I'm saying? Cause he happened to tap all over my mans and shit. And you know what happens from time to time.
Let me see, before the stoppage, old boy was pawing with the jab. And I don't know what he was doing before. He might have been throwing a straight behind it, but he fooled his ass and threw that uppercut right up the middle of that motherfucker. And I was like, yeah, J-Rock
won't
ready for none of that.
Hey, sure. Where you taking that uppercut from?
Yeah. Okay. So let's jump into the real shit. You know what I'm saying? The real shit. So we was talking on the phone, and you had the nerve to tell me that.
You had the nerve to tell me that
Demetrius Andre, Dudu Andre, Roddy Andre, whatever you want to call him. We can't do this conversation with you calling the grown man boo boo. We already know. You already down the point with that shit. So you say he better than Charlo? You know what I'm saying?
I feel, look. Look at it like this. You got killers, but then who's the most avoided in any weight class? A southpaw.
Okay.
So the man is avoided. You know what I'm saying? Charlo is a killer, but at the same time, he's not looking to jump into a damn fight with daggone fucking damn Demetrius like that. Because if you want to look back, who's been damn openly damn calling names?
Okay, so I'm glad you say that.
Who's openly calling names? You know what I'm saying? But then I know it all comes down behind the scenes. But you know what I'm saying? With the team, you know, is then gonna decide. But at the same time, somebody ain't putting a muzzle on Demetrius saying, "Hey, bro, stop calling damn Canelo, stop calling the Charlo, stop calling daggone Billy Joe, stop calling for these names." But hey, he's in. I'm letting motherfuckers know nobody is getting in here with me.
Okay. So let me put.
He's not saying that. No, you know what I'm saying? That he can't be beat. He's just saying, I'm trying to fucking fight, and nobody's, you know what I'm saying, willing to dag on sign on the line. Put me in here with these people. That's what I'm saying.
So
even damn, look, I even looked at Eddie Hearn. Eddie Hearn then reached out to Charlo, offered him some bread. I don't know if it's them big money or the fucking 4 for 4 from Wendy's. He offered him money, and ain't no damn response.
Yeah. Okay, so
I'm just saying.
So you know who he was with before he was with Eddie Hearn? Cause see all this that you talking about, I seen this movie before. The only problem was he was talking to the little Charlo. He was talking all that shit when he was at 154 and he had a belt and Charlo had the belt and everything was all Gucci and shit. But as soon as Charlo signed on the dotted line, he jumped out of the deal with Roc Nation and all that extra shit, you know what I'm saying? And fucked up the whole fight. So he actually was down one, you know what I'm saying? Now he wanna fight the bigger Charlo.
He's down one, but it's emotional issues.
If you got a problem with your bank,
you gonna jump ship, right?
No. I absolutely. So don't you think you need to take care of all your business before you out here trying to call for a fight? I mean, you know what I'm saying? If that's what we going on, because I don't see Charlo having a problem fighting him. I think they should fight because they need a fight. Both of them need a fight.
I know they need to fight. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So they're going to United States.
Yeah, that's necessary. So I definitely agree with that.
And I really think they on course to they going to fight, because if you look at their damn fight records and then you look at their schedules, these dudes are fighting within weeks apart. So training camp is not a damn issue for them to even make the fight happen. So I don't know what's going on behind the scenes. I see these damn young cats that are gonna call him for the fight. But I see Demetrius that are gonna call him for damn names. He's like, hey man, put me in with this motherfucker. Stop damn whatever it is.
But Demetrius, you know, okay, hold on, man. Cause see, you trying to make it sound like this dude nice. First off, this dude is from Rhode Island and he got a Rhode Island swag. You know what I'm saying? I don't care how you want to put it together. He got a weird ass Rhode Island swag. You know what I'm saying? For number one.
For number two,
him and Tevin Farmer are not stars. When these motherfuckers signed to Eddie Hearn, they had their press conference in the Denny's. What the fuck is we really talking about? You know what I'm saying? We in fucking Denny's having a press conference with these two goofy ass niggas. So you not gonna skip over that neither. Cause see, I was letting you give all these points out because I agree with all the shit you were saying, but you still wrong that saying he better than Charlo. Only thing that you and the only thing that's bad about Charlo,
and I feel he is because I'm a softball.
Yeah, but I mean,
and I gotta ride with him because I'm like, he's slippery as hell.
But you not goofy like that. You couldn't survive the Richmond streets like that. You couldn't survive Richmond streets being goofy like that. That's unacceptable and inappropriate. What are we talking about right now, man?
Every boxer in history that's ever given anybody problems has been awkward. Why are those styles the most avoided? They be like, that looks difficult. That don't look like it's going to look good on paper. That don't look good on my resume because I'm going to get touched too much. Don't look good because I stand a chance of getting hurt possibly because of what's going on.
He ain't got no fucking power.
A killer's gonna be a killer.
Man, this motherfucker.
But at the same time, a killer's still gonna be cautious depending on the heat. It's kind of that going awkward fighting this dude.
See, I told you.
He's an awkward fighter.
I'm gonna go back to it. The motherfucker has a Rhode Island swag. Do you know what that means? That means in his house, everything is off of candles because he has no power. He won't knock out shit. What the fuck is you talking about? That aqua shit don't matter nothing if you ain't doing nothing with it.
He got, 17, 18 knockouts?
Man, no. And he was fighting bum niggas. Hold on. In the last 2 years, since you want to talk about resume, in the last 2 years, he only fought one American. He been fighting goofy-ass Russians, Ukrainians, Croatians, and all that other old dumb-ass shit. And the last fight was in a Dunkin' Donuts arena. All the police in the world was in that bitch. Talking about we sold out. Free donuts. You know what I'm saying?
But neither one of them names on your resume.
Shit.
What name?
Hold on. First off.
Give me some names. Give me a second. I'm looking at your records right now.
Okay.
I'm looking at who they fought. And nobody's a damn killer on their damn list. Who's on either list?
That's a killer?
We can honestly say neither one of them has fought anybody elite. That's why they need to fucking fight.
Shit. Hold on. Charlo fought Austin Trout and he knocked out Julian Williams. What the fuck is we talking
about? Austin Trout was a shell of his old self.
Give me the shell that motherfucking Demetrius Andre beat. How about that? If he was a shell, you give me a shell to match it. Exactly. That's checkmate, that goofy ass nigga. And I'll end it with this.
What's the cat name? Arthur Dango Alcohol.
Man, we don't
That's
know.
The thing.
We don't believe you. You need more people, man. That don't count, man. He a shell. I never even seen the original version of this motherfucker. Let alone the shell. That's disrespectful. They need to fight, and I know Charlo gonna win, cause the only thing that could beat that awkward ass, goofy ass Rhode Island swag is tight ass pants and choker chains. So So all right, man, look, they calling for us. You know what I'm saying? I think, you got another topic? Oh, nah, the next topic I really wanted to ask you about was the Elder Alvarez before we get up out of here and shit. The Elder Alvarez fight. Did you see that?
I've seen the highlights of that. Yeah, that kid is hit or miss. It's all on depending on who he's in there with.
Okay, so how you feel about his style? Do you think that he can compete with the other type, top light heavyweight?
Give me a name.
Okay, so they got
maybe considered.
They got Dimitri Bivol, they got the boy Ghostick, and they got Better Beef just fought and unified. He unified at the light heavyweight. Mm-hmm. And they also got my man John Pascal that's doing the damn thing.
You know what I'm saying? How many fights did Pascal still got in him?
Pascal got, I don't know, shit. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? I know that shit.
But the first name you named, what's the kid them? Demetrius.
Dimitri Bivol.
The first name you named.
Yeah, Bivol.
Yeah, what was that? Yeah.
Yeah.
I seen that. Didn't he knock somebody out with a jab?
No. That probably was Better Beef. That probably was Better Beef that knocked somebody out. Bivol Moore is a boxer. He's slick as a motherfucker. He fought on the zone, but you know what I'm saying? His last fight to me wasn't all that. It was halfway a snooze fest. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
No, but the kid we talking about, the Alvarez kid, you saw his two fights against, was it two fights against Kovalev that he had?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he put Kovalev, he fucked down. You know what I'm saying? I see that.
But you saw he's kind of hit or miss.
I seen Kovalev get his ass back, too.
So he's dangerous, but he get in there with a boxer. He gonna have problems. You know what I'm saying? His style is tailor made for a boxer.
Okay, I don't know.
He's looking for that. He's looking to hurt you.
Yeah, but
the other
fighters at light heavyweight, that's nice, in my opinion. Like Better Beef, he gonna try to get it in with you. He got boxing style, but he trying to knock you the fuck out too. So
yeah,
that might turn out to be.
But I'd rather have that than the damn just being known as just a straight killer. I'd rather have them damn something in the reserve saying that, know what, I'ma box you, and then know what, I can switch you off, and they're gonna fucking make every punch have to wet you stiff.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's facts. That's
so
facts.
You gotta be able to turn this shit on and off. I think that's why I lean more so toward the actual boxer, because at any given time, I can stiffen up a punch and it'll feel like I'm a damn killer and not necessarily being a killer. You'd be like, damn, he had thud like that? Yes. You know what I'm saying? But I don't have to do that shit. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so before the last joint, we can just touch on it, you know what I'm saying, and we'll jump on it again next week, and that's the fight that's coming up. Wilder and Fury, what you thinking?
I'm going with Fury. It's gonna be a better fight this time, and I think them everybody's looking at Fury that he's gonna look like he's taking it serious.
Let him speak. Cause this gonna be good. No, I'm sorry. They try to cut you off. I try to tell them, let you talk. You know what I'm saying? I've been learning. I'm learning. I went to the class over the weekend. They put me in. We'll talk about that later. But yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
I think everybody carrying him in the sense that he ain't taking it serious, and I think he's damn playing chess right now. That's why damn it don't look like Fury damn is really invested in this shit. I think he's gonna come out there and keep boxing. He's talking that knockout shit. I think he's just gonna go right back into boxing mode and make them Wilder have to hunt for him.
Okay.
And Wilder's really gonna have to hunt for him this time, because I think he's gonna come in better shape. You know what I'm saying? Because I only say that because his last fight, that nasty ass cut he got. Who you know can dang gonna keep somebody off you for the rest of the damn fight with a gas that big and not have a referee step in and stop it?
Oh, I know who.
I know who. Yeah, but I'm just saying.
Oh, you lucky the time ran out. We'll wait till next week. Oh, you lucky. You lucky they got me. They got me. You lucky. All right. So we'll have to continue that next week. You know what I'm saying? And you could be up a point with that one. Because I'm we definitely going to get back to that one, man. So, all right. So all right, man. It's been a good one, man. It's been a good one, man. We'll chop it up next week. You know what I'm saying? And do it again. You know what I'm saying? Same channel. But I don't know about the time. We'll figure it out.